Hello, welcome to Fast Math Solutions on Maths with EJD. In this video, I'll be taking a two-part question. And the first part of the question is this. The A part of the question is this. Want to consider the Markov chain, with three states, S, which is 1, 2, 3, that has the transition matrix, the transition matrix, P equals half 1/4, 1/4. And then the next one is 1/3, 0, 2/3. And lastly, we have 1/2, 1/2, 0. Okay, so that matrix, that transition matrix, right? So the first thing we need to do is to draw the state transition, draw the state transition diagram, draw the state transition diagram for the chain, That's the first thing we need to do. The second thing we need to do is to is this. If the probability that x1 is equal to 1 is the same thing as the probability that x1 is equal to 2, and that is equal to 1/4, then we have to find probability that x2 equals 3, a probability x2 equals 3, comma probability x2 equals 2, and probability x3 equals 1. So that's the first part of the question. And then let's go ahead and do justice to that. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is to draw the state diagram. So to draw the state diagram. So for the state sake of clarity, I'm going to re rewrite the transition matrix. That is P equals what we had before, 1/2, 1/4, 1/4. And then we have 1/3, 0, 2/3. And then we have 1/2, 1/2, and 0. So this is the transition matrix. So one way to really have a good understanding of this is to show the state. You know, there are three possible states, right? The three possible states are 1, 2, and 3. So that means this is state 1, state 2, and state 3. And this is state 1, state 2, and state 3. So to draw the diagram, so let's see what we do here. So you can have state 1, this is S1. You can have state 2, S2, and then you have state 3, S3. So here you see that from state 1 to state 1, the probability is half. So we have from state 1 to itself, you have 1/2. Okay, from state 1 to state 2, the probability is 1/4. Then from state 1 to state 3, from state 1 to state 3, the probability is also 1/4, like that. Then we move on from state 2 to state 1, from state 2 back to state 1. The direction of the arrow is important. From state 2 back to state 1, it's 1/3. And then from state 2 to state 2, it's 0. So nothing moves from state 2 to state 2. But from state 2 to state 3, it's 2/3. So from state 2 to state 3, we have 2/3. And then we go to the last row. From state 2 to state 1 is half. So from state 3, right, that to state 1, that is this, from state 2 back to state 1, state 2 to state 1, that is 1 over 2. And from state 3 to state 1 is 1 over 2. And state 3 to state 2 is also 1 over 2. So from state 3 to state 2, like this, it's also 1 over 2. So with this, now you have the diagram. So that's the state diagram based on the transition matrix. Okay, so the second part of the question is what we go for next. And this is it. We have to find a particular probability. So we need to find, we have this, that if the probability of x1 equals 1 is the same thing as probability of x1 equals 2, and all of that is 1 over 4, then we need to find the probability that probability x2 equals 3, comma x2 equals 2, and x3 equals 1. We need to find this. Okay, so let's go again for that. Now what we need to understand here is this. If you had to solve this, right, you need to be able to move in the right direction. So and probably normally we move from, these are the time steps. Those two, two, three, they are the time steps. Whereas the states actually are this one. So moving from 1 to 2 and from 2 to 3, that's like the deal. So it's like so whatever, we don't know what had happened before, but then we know we started at 1. From 1 we move to 2, and from 2 we move to 3. So what we need to now deal with is this. Now this probability that x1, that if the first state is 1, is actually 1 over 4. So we need to take care of that. So this part is 1 over 4. Then what is the probability that the next movement is from 1 to 2, not from 1 to 3? The probability that it is from 1 to 2, we get from the state diagram. Probability moving from state 1 to state 2 is actually 1 over 4, as we can see on the diagram. And then lastly, what is probability from state 2 to state 3? Probability from state 2, well, we can even use this, from state 2 to state 3 is actually 2 over 3. Or from this diagram, state 2 to state 3 is 2 over 3. So, and that's what we have here. So with that, now we are good to go. So we can say, therefore, probability x2 equals 3, comma x2 equals 2, comma x3 equals 1 is the same thing as 1 over 4 times 1 over 4 times 2 over 3. And that is the same thing as 2 over 4 times 4, 16 times 3, 48. That is 2 over 48, which is the same thing as 1 over 24. So that's the solution to that first part of the question. So let's move to the B part of the question. The B part of the question. So again, we have something close to that. We want to consider a system that can be in one of two possible states, one or two possible st of two possible states, S, that is 0 or 1, 0 or 1. So now we now suppose the matrix is given. Suppose the matrix is given by P equals 1 over 2, 1 over 2, and then 1 over 3, 2 over 3, right? So this is the transition matrix. Suppose the matrix is given like that, and the system is in state 0 at n equals 0, that is at time t equals, that is x of 0 is 0. So at when nothing had happened, the state was actually, the beginning point is 0, right? So we now have to do this one, draw the state transition diagram. Draw the state transition diagram. Okay, that's the first part. And number two, we are to find the probability that the system the system, the probability that the system is in state one, is in state one at time n equals 3. So it means after three movements have been made, the location of the system is at point one. That's all we have to do. So of course, let's go again and deal with that as we need to. So, okay, let's do that. Solution. Again, to draw the state transition diagram, the state transition diagram, transition diagram, to draw the state transition diagram, what happens? We need to get the transition matrix, and the transition matrix we know is P, which is 1 over 2, 1 over 2, 1 over 3, and 2 over 3. That is that. And then we have to indicate. So this is, there are two states, 0 and 1. Two states, 0 comma 1. So it means this is state 0 and this is state 1. This is state 0 and this is state 1. Okay. So in this case now we have okay, let me change. So we have state 0 and we have state 1 like that. So you see, from moving from state 0 to state 0 is 1 over 2. From state 0 to state 1 is 1 over 2. Then we have moving from state 1 to state 0. From state 1 to state 0, it's 1 over 3. And from state 1 to state 1 is 2 over 3, like that. So that's the transition, the state transition diagram. So the second part is we want to find the probability, right? We want to find the probability that the system is in state 1 at time n equals 3. So to find the probability that the system is in state one at n equals 3, that after three time steps. So that is what we need to do now. So in summary, you can put it like this. You want the probability that you move from 0. After three time steps, you get to 1. So that means probability 3, 0, 1. And the way to do this is this, that the transition matrix, right? So it means you're going to get the transition matrix 1 over 2, 1 over 2, 1 over 3, 2 over 3, and you raise it to power 3. And by the time you get the results, then state 0, 1 means you're moving from, this is S1, I mean S0, S1, S0, S1. So what you're doing is, so from S0 to S1, this is this point. So by the time you finish multiplying this matrix out, whatever is in this location is the probability you're looking for. So it means the journey we have to embark on is to now get the this matrix raised to power 3. So I can actually go ahead and give the result, but then let me take my time to work that out. So now we have P 0 1. So you want to move from 0 to 1 after three time steps, and you want to find what the probability is. So this simply means you're going to have 1 over 2, 1 over 2, then 1 over 3, 1 over 3, 2 over 3. This can really be confusing, so you need to be very careful. Maybe one thing that also helps is you can actually, if you have a calculator, you can already punch a calculator and know what the answer should be before you even start solving. So once you make a mistake, you know easily. Okay, so this is very important. So you want to multiply this by itself three times. So the first thing you want to do is probably take care of these two first. And my method for multiplying, I've already explained that in my series on matrix multiplication. So you want to check that out in the matrices playlist. So since you have two rows here, so you have to write these columns twice. Okay, what I mean by that is, so for this 1 over 2, 1 over 3, you write it twice, 1 over 2, 1 over 3. And the next one, 1 over 2, 2 over 3, then 1 over 2, 2 over 3. And then you invert these ones on it. That is 1 over 2, 1 over 2, again, 1 over 2, 1 over 2. And for the next one, you have 1 over 3, 2 over 3, right? And then 1 over 2, I mean 1 over 3, 1 over 3, 2 over 3. So you have all this. Of course, you still have 1 over 2, 1 over 2, 1 over 3, 2 over 3. So let's tidy this first part up first. So to tidy this up now, you know, this is simply this 1 over 2 times 1 over 2, that's 1 over 4 plus 1 over 6, you know, this. Then the next one, you have 1 over 4 plus 2 over 6, you know, which is still the same thing as one. So it's the same thing as 1 over 3, right? That's 1 over 2 times 1 over 2, that's 1 over 4. 2 over 3 times 1 over 2, that's 1 over 3, okay? And then this part is 1 over 2 times 1 over 3, that's 1 over 6, plus 1 over 3 times 2 over 3, that is 2 over 9. And then here you have 1 over 2 times 1 over 2, that's 1 over 6. And here 2 over 3 times 2 over 3, that is plus 4 over 9. So you have this, and then you have 1 over 2, 1 over 2, 1 over 3, 2 over 3. Okay? So tidying this left side up, 1 over 4 plus 1 over 6, 1 over 4 plus 1 over 6, that plus, right? So that's LCM is 12. 4 in 12 is 3. 6 in 12 is 2. So that is 5 over 12. So you have 5 over 12 here. And then the next one, you have 1 over 4 plus 1 over 3. So LCM is 12 again. That's 3 plus 4. So this is 7 over 12. Then the last, this other part, you have 1 over 6 plus 2 over 9. The LCM is 18, I think. Yeah. So 6 in 18, 3. 9 in 18, 2. 2 times 2 is 4. So you have 7 over 18 down here. You have 7 over 18 down here. And then this part, you have 1 over 6 plus 4 over 9. The LCM again is 18. So 6 in 18 is 3. 9 in 18 is 2 times 4. That's 8. So you have 11 over 18 right here. So this is 11 over 18. So this goes, of course, don't forget, okay, and all of that into 1 over 2, 1 over 2, 1 over 3, 2 over 3. Of course, this is just an aside. So that's just us trying to get those fine details. Okay. So don't forget what we are, it's still P01 at time step 3 that we are looking for. So now that we have this, we have to go again and expand. So we can now say P01 at time step 3 again is, so what we did before, we do it again. So you want to multiply these two together, and then you have two rows here. So the first, so it means you have to write this once twice, you know, because you have two rows. So you have 1 over 2, 1 over 3 again, 1 over 2, 1 over 3 again. Then you have 1 over 2, 2 over 3, 1 over 2, 2 over 3. And then you put this over it, 5, this 5 over 12, 7 over 12, and 5 over 12, 7 over 12. And here you have 7 over 18, 7 over 18, 11 over 18. Again, 7 over 18, 11 over 18. So you just tidy that up. You have, you know, this is 5 over 24, 5 over 24 plus 7 over 36 there. Then here, you have 5 over 24, 5 over 24 plus 14. 14 over 36, or better still, 7 over 18. But I think it's okay like that if you still leave it that way. So here you have 7 over 36 plus 11 over 54. And here you have 7 over 36, 7 over 36 plus 22 over 54. Okay. So, of course, I'll just go straight and write out the answer. So if you do the arithmetic, you get the answer correctly. So this is now P01 at time step 3 is actually, so if you add up all that, you get 29 over 72, you get 43 over 72, and you get 43 over 108, 43 over 108, and 65 over 108. 8. And this is what you have. Actually, right? Maybe I think the better way I should have written this is this. You know, we actually need we know P P01 is actually that location, but all we've been doing so far, all these things we've been doing, is actually the P3, right? The probability of the transition matrix at time step 3. So maybe I do have to add the 01 for now. So until the end. So it's just this 01 first. Yeah. So this is the P3. This is the transition matrix at time step 3. At time step 3, this is the transition matrix. But what we actually need is that at that time step 3, right? At that time step 3, what is 01? You know, what is like the transition 01? And that is what you do now. So this is S0, this is S1, this is S0, this is S1. So 01 is like, so 0 to S, S0 to S1. So it means that probability that at time step 3, at time step n equals 3, the probability is simply 43 over 72. So you remember that what we are looking for is the probability that at n equals 3, you know, we are looking for the probability that the system is in state 1 at n equals 3. So we now say, therefore, the probability that the system is in state 1 at time n equals 3 is P01 at step 3, and that is 43 over 72. And of course, you can do that into decimal if necessary. 43 over 72 in decimal, that may also help. 43 over 72 in decimal is actually 0.5, let me say 5972, you know, 0.59 72. So we can have that. So with that, we come to the end of this particular video. So go over it and be sure you understand. Thank you so much for listening. If you have not subscribed to this channel, please do that and be sure to hit the notification bell so that anytime I release a new video, you get alerted. And then please share with others because I know many people will need these things. And of course, comment. For instance, this question is actually from one of my viewers who requested for this to be solved, you know. So you could actually do that and then we'll find time to attend to your questions. Thank you so much for listening. See you in the next video.